Hello, my name's Leslie Kelly and this is my writing space. I have written a number of novels, five of them in total. The first one was called A Fine House in Trinity, and I live in Edinburgh, and Trinity is an area of Edinburgh, and if the camera angle can swing round, we should just get a view of the rooftops of Trinity out there. So obviously I didn't look very far for inspiration for my first novel. With my second novel, I'm actually writing a series. This is the Health of Strangers series, which is crime novels, again set in Edinburgh, but against the background of a pandemic, which has suddenly become unexpectedly topical. Now, the pandemic in this book, also a virus, and we focus on the health enforcement team, who are the people who come and hunt you down if you don't turn up for your health check. So four books in the series, and the latest one is out in April. It's quite ironic trying to launch a book about a pandemic in the middle of a pandemic, and it was very influenced by my work. Work for the voluntary sector, and we spend a lot of time in meetings with the council and the NHS, police, people like that, discussing emergency planning issues. So that kind of influenced the book, and of course we're in the emergency situation, has meant that we're all working from home. So I'm sharing my working space at the moment with the other members of my family. My husband's working in the other room, and usually I share this desk with my son, who is at primary school, and fortunate in the fact that it is a huge desk. I've got my other son behind the camera here, so maybe if he can swing the camera around so we can see the enormity of the desk that we're actually talking about here, which we bought on auction and didn't realise quite how big it was until we got it home and tried to get it up a flight of stairs. So my younger son absolutely refused to have anything to do with the video, so in his place we'll just kind of have a look at some other exhibits, which are, my other son will agree, behind the camera, far better looking than him. And this is some exhibits from the second book that I have here, The Death at the Plague Museum, where the activity took place in a museum, and it was a museum of exhibits all dedicated to plagues and pandemics. So we had the chimpanzees, obviously, quite responsible for a number of viruses that we've had in the past. And we also had a range of pockets full of posies that people used probably futilely to protect themselves against plague, and obviously featured in the nursery rhyme, Pocket Full of Posies. And then we had the plague doctor, which people used and wore these things in the middle of the plague and filled them up with posies at the front, again in a doomed attempt probably to protect themselves from plagues and pandemics. And it's amazing the things you have lying about your house if you write novels about pandemics. Anyway, to finish off, I just wanted to talk a little bit about what I've been reading to get me through the terrible times of lockdown. And I've got a range of crime novels on the go. First one is the award-winning novel by Margaret Kirk, Shadowman, which very much enjoying. It introduces us to D.I. Lucas Mahler. And it's a great book, really enjoying it, and also has the best ever description I've read in literature of a sausage roll, so worth it for that alone. Next up on my to-be-read list are a couple of series that I'm midway through. Ben Aronovich, if you like your crime with a dose of magic, and I very much do, absolutely excellent series, very funny. And another one that's very dark and very funny is McHerrin's Slough House series, which is about spies. Another Scottish crime writer, Douglas Skelton. This is the second book in a series. I read the first one, Thunder Bay, and really, really enjoyed it. And all the reviews that I've read say the second one's even better. So very much looking forward to getting stuck into that. And last but not least, we've got one about vampires, crime novel about vampires. This is Miss Blaine's Prefect and the Vampire Menace by Olga Woltas. And it's absolutely hilarious. So I totally recommend that to everyone as well. So that was a whistle-stop tour of my writing area. Thank you very much for your time.